So if we have a chance to sing four verses, we'll do 101. One Spanish, one English, and the refrain.
The Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry. All who dwell in darkness, my hand. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Oh, will there my light to them? Whom shall I send? Yo, Señor de cielo y mar, que llore de escuchar a los que sufriendo están, quiero salvar. Aquí estoy, Señor, heme aquí, Señor.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
Welcome again to this, I guess, the first Wednesday bilingual Mass in our parish. Hope we shall enjoy the going and praise God. And for those joining us online, we shall be having bilingual Masses on Wednesdays at noon. So bear with us, pray with us, and let's worship the Lord who makes us be here today. El nombre del Padre, del Hijo, del Espíritu Santo. La gracia de nuestro Señor Jesucristo y el amor del Padre y la comunión del Espíritu Santo estén con todos ustedes.
Y con tu espíritu.
Hermanos, para celebrar dignamente estos sagrados misterios, reconozcamos nuestros pecados. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. Draw near to your servants, O Lord, and answer their prayers with unceasing kindness, that for those who glory in you as their creator and guide, you may restore what you have created and keep safe what you have restored. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Lectura del profeta Jeremías. Esto dice el Señor en aquel tiempo: yo seré el Dios de todas las tribus de Israel, y ellos serán mi pueblo. El pueblo de Israel, que se libró de la espada, halló misericordia en el desierto y camina hacia el descanso. El Señor se le apareció de lejos. Esto dice el Señor: yo te amo con amor eterno, por eso siempre me apiado de ti. Volveré pues a construirte, y serás reconstruida, capital de Israel. Volverás a tocar tus panderos, y saldrás a bailar entre músicos y coros. Volverás a plantar viñas en los montes de Samaria, y los que las planten las disfrutarán. En la montaña de Efraín gritarán los centinelas: ya es de día, levántense y vayamos a Sion, hacia el Señor, nuestro Dios. Esto dice el Señor: griten de alegría por Jacob, regocíjense por el mejor de los pueblos, proclamen, alaben y digan: el Señor ha salvado a su pueblo, al grupo de los sobrevivientes de Israel. Palabra de Dios.
Te alabamos, Señor.
The Lord will guard us as a shepherd guards his flock. The Lord will guard us as a shepherd guards his flock. Hear the word of the Lord, O nations. Proclaim it on distant isles and say, he who scattered Israel now gathers them together. He guards them as a shepherd guards his flock. The Lord will guard us as a shepherd guards his flock. Porque el Señor redimió a Jacob y lo rescató de las manos del poderoso. Ellos vendrán para aclamar al monte Sion y vendrán a gozar de los bienes del Señor. The Lord will guard us as a shepherd guards his flock. Then the virgins shall make merry and dance, and young men and old as well. I will turn their mourning into joy. I will console and gladden them after their sorrows. The Lord will guard us as a shepherd guards his flock.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Un gran profeta ha surgido entre nosotros. Dios ha visitado a su pueblo. Aleluya, aleluya, aleluya.
The Lord be with you.
Spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus withdrew to the region of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a Canaanite woman of that district came and called out, have pity on me, Lord, son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon, but did not say a word in answer to her. His disciples came and asked him, send her away, for she keeps calling out after us. He said in reply, I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. But the woman came and did him homage, saying, Lord, help me. He said in reply, it is not right to take the food of children and throw it to the dogs. She said, please, Lord, for even the dogs eat the scraps that fall from the table of their masters. Then Jesus said to her in reply, O woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish. And her daughter was healed from that hour. The Gospel of the Lord.
Jesus Christ.
Today, I present few questions to you. And the first question that I may pose is this. Do we easily give up when we face challenges? Do we easily give up when we face challenges? Or do we stay the course of our faith even during tough times?
Do we stay the course of our faith even during tough times? Do we remain faithful even when our prayers seem to go unanswered? Do we believe that our God has enough blessings for each and every one of us, regardless of our history, regardless of our class, regardless of our education or our politics? Do we believe that He has enough blessings for each of us, for every one of us? Those questions may take time to reflect. We come from different backgrounds. We come from different cultures. We come from different families and different upbringing. But there is one thing we are being taught today by the Canaanite woman. Regardless of where we come from, for us to be successful in our faith, we must have an undying belief. An undying belief. Put it the other way. We must have an undying faith, a faith that is focused, a faith that does not get swayed by the challenges of life. This woman teaches us how to have a tenacity of faith, a faith that stands even amidst challenges, a stimulated faith, a strengthened faith, a faith that is focused unshakable. When Jesus responded to the lady or to the Canaanite woman, she did not walk away in discouragement, even by the words Jesus used and said, "It is not right to pick the food that belongs to children and throw it to dogs." If somebody was to reflect on those statements alone in our cultural perspective today and our society as we stand today, that is very insulting. How dare you call a human being a dog? But because of our faith, she looked beyond the words and she understood that the response that came from Jesus was a challenge to see how our faith will make her react. She could have walked away. How dare you call me a dog? I'm a human person. But because she looked beyond the words of Jesus, she waited for a time to be blessed. She waited for that hour of the blessing. She waited for that hour for the daughter to be healed. She waited for a turn. That's why she responded and said, "Oh, no, I know. You may be sent to the sons and daughters of Israel, but remember, you have enough for them and for me too." That's why she said, "Even dogs eat the scraps that come from the master's table." She's telling him, "I don't care what you tell me, but I know who you are. You are a merciful God. You care for me, and you are going to bless me, and I'm not walking away until you give me that blessing." And what's the response that comes from Jesus? "Oh, woman, may it be done to you as you request." Because she never walked away, she waited for a turn for the blessing, and she knew Jesus had enough blessings for the people he was sent to and for the rest of us. We also, we are sons and daughters of God through baptism. We have a share in those blessings. So what do? We wait for our time, for a blessing. Even when our prayers seem to go unanswered, wait for your time. Wait for your turn. Don't walk away from him. Remind him that he has enough for all of us. And here, she's acting on behalf of the daughter. The question would be, why is she bothered? It's because she was a good intercessor. She interceded for the daughter. How many times do we intercede for others? How many times do we sacrifice humiliation for the sake of others? She was humiliated being called a dog. How many times have we withstood humiliations in order for us to bless other people, to stand in the gap for other people who are suffering? The Lord is calling us today to stay with him, to wait for our turn for a blessing, and to be good intercessors until that hour when the anointing of the Lord comes upon us. May you not walk away from the Lord when you face challenges. May you have undying faith, a faith that sees beyond the daily challenges, a faith that sees the promises of God, a faith that sees the mercy and love of God amidst all the challenges. Now bring our petitions to the Lord, that inspired by the faith of the Canaanite woman, we too come to the Lord with our needs. For all priests and religious, may the Lord continue to bless them in their vocations. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For state and federal leaders, may the grace of the Holy Spirit empower them in their efforts in protecting all life from conception to natural death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who experience doubt that God hears their prayers, may the peace of Christ console them and strengthen their faith. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For this faith community of St. Luke, may the Holy Spirit empower us to bear good fruit for the glory of God. Let us pray to the Lord. For all the faithful departed, particularly those who have no one else to pray for them, may they be welcomed into the heavenly Jerusalem. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for our special intentions for Lindy Elizondo and Marguerite Camper, and the petitions in our hearts, and the petitions of those who are worshiping with us online. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Father of love and mercy, you know our every need. We ask you to graciously hear our prayers in the name of your Son, who is Christ the Lord. Amen.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see. Sublime gracia del Señor, que a un infeliz salvó. Fui ciego, mas hoy veo yo, pierdo y he
Pray, my brothers and sisters, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands.
For the praise and glory of his name.
For our good and good of all his holy church.
Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray. And accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make us an eternal offering to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
El Señor esté con ustedes.
Y con tu espíritu.
Levantamos el corazón.
Lo tenemos levantado hacia el Señor.
Demos gracias al Señor nuestro Dios.
Es justo y necesario.
En verdad es justo y necesario. Y nuestro deber y salvación darle gracias siempre en todo lugar, Señor Padre Santo, Dios Todopoderoso y Eterno, porque Cristo nuestro Señor.
Amén.
El cual, al venir por vez primera en la humildad de nuestra carne, realzó el plan de redención trasero de este antiguo y nos abrió el camino de salvación para que cuando venga de nuevo en la majestad de su gloria, revelando así la plenitud de su obra, podamos recibir los bienes prometidos que ahora en vigilante espera confiamos alcanzar. Por eso, con los ángeles y arcángeles y con todos los coros celestiales cantamos sin cesar el himno de tu gloria.
Santo, santo, santo es el Señor, Dios del universo, llenos están el cielo y la tierra de tu gloria, hosana en el cielo. Bendito el que viene en el nombre del Señor, hosana en el cielo.
Santo eres en verdad, Señor, fuente de toda santidad, por eso te pedimos que santifiques estos dones con la difusión de tu Espíritu, de manera que sean para nosotros cuerpo, el sangre de Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
Amén.
A cual, cuando iba a ser entregado a su pasión voluntariamente aceptada, tomó pan. Da donde gracia lo pasó y lo dio a sus discípulos diciendo, tomen y comen todos de él, porque esto es en mi cuerpo, que será entregado por ustedes. Del mismo modo, acabada la cena, tomó el cáliz y dándole gracias de nuevo, le pasó a sus discípulos diciendo, tomen y beban todos de él, porque este es el cáliz de mi sangre, sangre de alianza y nueva eterna, que será derramada por ustedes y por todos los hombres para el perdón de los pecados. Hagan esto en conmemoración mía. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection
until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, O Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring out the fullness of charity together with the friends of our Pope, Gustav, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise you and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Por Cristo con él y en él. El Dios Padre Omnipotente, en la unidad del Espíritu Santo, dando honor y toda gloria por los siglos de los siglos.
Amen. Amen.
And now let us pray the Father in the words of our Savior taught us, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours,
now and forever.
Señor Jesucristo, que diste a los apóstoles la paz, les dio mi paz, les doy. No tengas en cuanto nuestro pecado, sino la fe de tu iglesia, y conforme a tu palabra, concede la paz y la unidad, tú que vives y reinas por los siglos de los siglos.
Amén.
La paz del Señor esté siempre con ustedes.
Y con tu espíritu.
Dense fraternalmente la paz. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we, called the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say a word. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Amen.
And now it's time for communion. For those who may not receive, you fold your hands over your chest and you shall receive a blessing.
Sacrifice, giving thanks, hungry ones gather round. Eat all of you and be satisfied. In Christ's presence, the loaves will abound. Bread of life from heaven. Bread. until you come again. Ande vida eterna, nos das tu cuerpo y sangre, hasta que vuelvas tú, Señor, comemos de tu amor. Ven y comparte el divino pan, demos gracias con gran corazón. Cristo es sustento que unirá a los miembros de cada nación. Bread of life from heaven, your blood and body given, we eat this bread and drink this cup until you come. Ande vida eterna, nos das tu cuerpo y sangre, hasta que vuelvas tú, Señor, comemos de tu amor.
And for those of us who are unable to receive communion, let us make a spiritual communion with our Lord by praying together. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as you are already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Accompany with the constant protection, O Lord, those you renew with these heavenly gifts, and in your never failing care for them, make them worthy of eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And before you go, I have seen a friend of mine, one of our seminarians, and I would like to say thank you for coming to visit with us and celebrate Mass with us. He may just wave so that you may see him over there. He's as you pray for seminarians, pray for all those who serve in various ministries, and especially for those who serve us through media ministry, and all those others involved, even reaching out to our seniors and to those at home, we still love you, and we commune with you in our hearts, and we pray with you. May you continue keeping the faith, undying faith, so that we see beyond the challenges of life. We see beyond the challenges of our faith and live to receive the blessing. Don't walk away. Stay there until he blesses you, okay? Even when you feel you are almost insulting me, I'm still staying until you bless me. El Señor esté con ustedes.
Y con tu espíritu.
La bendición de Dios Todopoderoso, Padre, Hijo, el Espíritu Santo, descienda sobre ustedes.
Amen.
Go in peace. Our Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
I will come to you in the silence. I will lift you from all your fears. You
will hear my voice. I claim you as my choice. Be still and know I am here.
Te hablaré en la paz del silencio y del miedo te libraré. Mi voz escucharás y mío tú serás, junto a ti estaré. Do not be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by name. Come and follow me, I will bring you home. I love you and you are mine. Aquí estoy contigo, no temas. Yo por nombre te llamé. Ven y sígueme, yo te llevaré. Te amo y contigo estoy.